a Juan ahí con Yamel. kuwezesha. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Ningependa tu kwa dakika moja, dakika moja tu, kwa sababu ya uwezo na uwepo wa Mungu ulio mahali hapa. Ningependa tu hizo vyombo tu vilie tu kwa dakika chache tu kumshukuru Mungu. Haleluya. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. praise. Holy God, we give you worship. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, who was sacrificed for our sins. We worship you this morning. We praise your name, Lord. We welcome you, Lord, in our lives, in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh my God, we worship you, we honor you, God. You're excellent, Lord, you're mighty, Jesus. We love you, Father. We love you, God. We love you, Spirit of the Most High, God. Thank you, Father. We have blessed you this morning. We have blessed you, Lord, as the Lord of our lives. We submit unto you, Lord of grace. And mercy upon us, Lord. Father, wash away and cleanse us from our sins, our iniquities, Lord. May you wash away our sins by your blood, Lord. Make us worthy before your presence, Lord, in this morning. In the name of Jesus Christ, that as we worship you this morning, as we sing praises unto you, Lord, let them come to you, Father, as a sweet smelling aroma, Father. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, do not hold us, Lord, for our sins. Have mercy and forgive us, Lord. And Lord, accept us, Lord. Accept us, Lord. We come to you. Lord, we come to you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ. For I pass unto you what I received from the Lord. The night that Jesus was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he said, "This is my body broken for you. As often as you take it, do it in remembrance of me." Let us give thanks, Father, in the name of Jesus. As we partake of the bread this morning, we are praying that every property that was in your body, Lord, which you block for your disciples, we pray as your children this morning, and it shall be the same property that comes to this bread, that as we partake it, Lord, and it shall be well unto our bodies. Lord, you are coming to correct everything in our body which is not right, that they may be right this morning. Our body shall receive the immunity that was in your blood, that was in your body, in the name of Jesus. And it shall receive the power to overcome everything that your body overcame when you are in this world. We are doing it in remembrance of you. In the same manner, he took a cup. He took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he said, "This is the new covenant in my blood, which is sealed in my blood. As you partake it, do it in remembrance of me." Father, we want to present this cup before you. It is a covenant in the new blood, in the blood of Jesus. As you partake it, Lord, we are your children in the vineyard, serving you, Lord. We pray that the blood that came through you at the cross shall make our life new. You are going to resurrect what is dead in us, in the name of Jesus. You are going to break everything that is not right in us, in the name of Jesus. Curses will be broken. Power of darkness will be broken, in the name of Jesus. Our weakness shall become strength by taking of your blood, in the name of Jesus Christ. You are going to solve every issue concerning our life, because we are going to receive the power that came with your blood. We give you praise. In Jesus' name, we do pray and believe.
Amen. Amen. This is a very precious moment when we are coming to partake of the body and the blood of Jesus. All that the world sees is that we need to partake of it in a worthy manner, not in an unworthy manner. This is not just another moment to celebrate what we have, but it's another moment to see what Jesus did for us on the cross. It carries life and it also carries death. Death for anyone who partake it in an unworthy manner, but life for those who partake it in a worthy manner. So as a believer, if you are here, all that you should do is to go before God, tell God to forgive you every sin in you that can cause it to become a death in your life. So that as you partake it, it will not become judgment. It shall make you have life and the fullness of life that Jesus intended to give when he died for us. It was not intended for us to die, to suffer. It was intended for us to receive that grace that was with Jesus. So just bow down. Even when you receive it, you will ask God that you need to receive from him. So you will take this mtachukua mshikilie, na nweni ukipata mshikilie, ninakuomba usishikilie tu, enda mbele ya Mungu. Unapoishika, ujue umeshika nini, ujue umeshika uhai, umeshika nguvu ya Yesu. Ushikilie ukiwa unaambia Mungu kile unataka, so that even when you will be partaking of it, it shall not be the same again in your life, in the name of Jesus. So I ask the servants, please, to come forward as our ushers wanatusaidia to sanitize watu. Wale wako tusaidie to sanitize watu, alafu viongozi nao wanakuwa wakisafi. Karibuni sana, tuweze kuharakisha masaa so that we can move on.
Yeah.
Lord Jesus, the maker of our lives, who loved us so much that he gave himself for us. He died for you. He died for me. What we are about to take, it is the painful death of Jesus at the cross. We cannot dare do it in another manner. Ask God to forgive you. Repent all your sins this morning. See what Jesus did and actualize it in your mind and in your heart, so that as you partake of this Holy Communion, it shall become a power in your life. Your body is going to receive the power that was in the body of Jesus. Your blood is going to receive every power that was in the blood of Jesus. Your life can never be the same again. Nothing can overcome you once you carry this in your life. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Spirit of God, transfuse what it was in the blood of Jesus into this blood that you are partaking. What was in the body of Jesus, may it come right in the body of your children this morning. Let them overcome all sickness and diseases, every manner of problems. Let them die now. In Jesus' name, let us partake. It is time to thank God for the accomplishment of the cross. There can never be a greater sacrifice than that which was given to us. There can never be a greater sacrifice than that. There can never be a greater love than what was shown by God on the cross. Nothing can be greater than that. Even if you are given the wealth of the whole world, it can never be equal to the death of a Savior to you and to my life. Just say thank you to Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. My God, thank you. Diseases are melting. Curses are melting. Power of darkness is melting. In the name of Jesus, people are receiving deliverance in their lives. In the name of Jesus, power of God is flowing in the lives of his people this morning. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for doing it. We give you praise. We give you honor. In Jesus' name, we will pray and believe.
Amen.
God bless you. Let's go on.
So this is not just a song that we are singing this morning. It is a proclamation we are making that we are coming into the days of Elijah. The days that you will have authority to say, this thing will not happen until I say so. The days of Elijah, when you're going to say that if Baal is God, we shall know today. When God is going to show a distinction,
oh, yes.
between himself and the bar. We are entering the days of the light. So let us go together as we sing, "These are the days of the light," in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
As much as I'm tempted for us to sing another song, let us sit down and hear the word. Hallelujah. I want to bless the Lord for the praise team. These are new servants of God, and they have given a lot of time to God. Many of them were here before 8 a.m. Some of them quite come from very far. That means there is a possibility some of them left home before 7 a.m. just to come here. Last night they left here almost at 7 p.m. May God reward you, praise Him, for that dedication. Amen. I bless the Lord for what He's doing in our midst. I have no doubt when we say these are the days of the light. I have no doubt completely in my heart. We have entered a different season before God. The things that God is doing are amazing. God is putting us into a realm of starting to live a supernatural life. God wants us to start living supernaturally. He has proved it. He is able to do it. This morning, God was warning us against trusting in men. If you are there and you are been trusting in people, you better stop that now and focus on God. God wants to help us directly. It is true, we may use people, but don't now fix your eyes on people. God is not happy with some of us who are fixing their eyes on people. Some who are even fixing their eyes on politicians. Get your eyes from those politicians. Get your eyes from that rich relative. Focus on God. Praise the Lord. Because God wants to help us. He has proved. He has proved it. He has proved it. On Friday, I was singing to Him alone that I have proved it over and over. I have proved you over and over. And it is true, I have proved God over and over. God is very serious with what He is telling us. Praise the Lord. Let me not say everything. Remind me to give some announcements after the service when we are not in the camera. Praise the Lord. Some things are just meant for us. I'll say that sometimes I just forget and go overboard. So I'm excited. I'm excited as God, brethren. I have never enjoyed God like I'm enjoying. I'm just enjoying to serve God. Trying to serve God. Allow me to go straight to the word because we don't have a lot of time. I have a word that I wish we had a lot of time to expound. Actually, I realized I may need a conference to speak this. But now I have only this service. How I wish that everybody was here to hear this message. But unfortunately, those that are coming for the second service will have a different message. Those in an that in a different message. So what I pray is that those that will come for other services, let them listen to this message online. Let them go to Facebook and listen to it or to YouTube. You can get this message and share it on your WhatsApp group, on YouTube channels. Just post it there. There are some things that God is speaking, and sometimes I keep asking God, why don't you allow us to speak to everybody now? But you know we can't, because we are limited to the number of people we can have in the church. The message I spoke in the midweek service, I was feeling like I can go preaching it from house to house. But it was not possible. And you know, midweek service is not a very popular service. Many of you don't come. But then God gives a big message. God troubled me with a message. The time of your visitation, I spoke it. I thank God for Juliana, she was recording it, so you can get it on Facebook. Get it on Facebook and listen to what God is speaking. Some of you missed it. So be attentive. Get your book and write. If you stop the culture of coming with the books and pens and Bibles, please let us go back to that culture. Yes. It is good. Yes. A real Bible, not this one of Facebook or the Bible of the phone. Start coming back with your Bibles, brethren. You know this Bible of the phone? Sometimes we even come to preach with the phone here. Unless you customize it in a way that it is just the Bible. Like when because sometimes I realize, have you seen preachers preaching and then the Bible starts ringing? Say, my sorry, brethren. No, you can't. Those are jokes before God. You can't come with a Bible and come in a picture simu. Have you seen sometimes your phone in a kuletanga pictures is your poker?
Mm-hmm.
In a kuletanga to be called in, and it's your Bible now. You are here with your Bible and rough in me. So I didn't talk about to be around in a kuletanga to be to happen to your poker. I know we are in the age of technology. But let us have brethren carrying real Bibles. As much as we are using these phones, let us carry real Bibles. Let us not just depend on this. I know many people have stopped coming with Bibles, but with Bible and come up on very squeeze. And he's done the Muyona Kikwa Makwa. And then the day you go, Master Sore, Hauna Bible. This is good. It is good to learn to carry a Bible. If you don't have a Bible, actually it makes sense if you sell your phone and buy a Bible. And sell your phone and buy a Bible. They are not the same. Although the phone is in the Bible, the Bible is in the phone, they are not the same. They are not equivalent. So if you don't have a physical Bible, go and sell your phone and buy a Bible. And read it and underline it and keep marking and reading the Bible. Hallelujah. Let's pray. Father, we thank you and bless you. This short while that we have to hear your word, minister to us, King of glory. Speak to us, Jesus, in a special way. In Jesus' name we pray. We have been praying and ended the prayer 21 days. And if you are not aware, we are about to start again. Because the things that God has done in 21 days have encouraged me so much that we continue. Don't worry. No, no, you don't answer to sad. I will not involve everybody. This time it will be prayers for the willing. We will not say it is the whole church, but we are going to say prayers for those who are willing to enter. I know some people have lost weight. Don't worry, God will give you new clothes. There are some people I see in our midst who will need a new wardrobe. Don't worry, God will give you. But we are going to pray over and over. Because there are things that God has done, and I was asking, if God has done this just in 21 days, supposing we prayed for 3 months, my goodness. So we are about to start again actually next week, but one. So those who want to join the prayers, we will have special instructions after every service. So even in this service, if you will not be there at the end of the services, let us meet, come to the office. If you want to be part of those prayers, the 21 days, we will see how to do it. But this week, we'll be doing some preparation. I want to give some instructions for this week. Then we start next week, part one. The reason I can't really start tomorrow, it is a serious business at this preparation. You can't just say, what's the question? No. It needs preparation. So those that don't mind, those that are saying, I don't mind losing some kgs, come, let us go together. Praise the Lord. But when we have been praying, one day we set it apart and we said we wanted to get dominion in the spiritual realm. Were you following that? Those who are praying, we want to get dominion over devils and demons. There is a day we set aside for that. And when I was praying that day, one thing I kept praying is that God show us the spirit that is in charge of this region. I wanted to know which spirit has been ruling in this region. And you know God is so faithful. Actually, God revealed the spirit through several people in our ministry. And I thank God for those who have been keen and hearing from God and saying, Pastor, I'm excited when people come and say, Pastor, I had this dream, I don't even know what it means, but what can I come here to? And it is good when you get them to just come and tell me. Some of them I also don't understand when you tell me, they start making sense later. So some people tell me, Pastor, I had a vision, I don't know what it means, but let me just tell you. When you get it, just tell me. Some people want the fear, start fearing. How will pastor take it if I tell him now? Don't mind. When God told it to you, how did you take it? I'll just take it like that and wait on God. And God will speak to us. But God has been so gracious. He revealed to us some spirits that have been ruling. And I want to just expose one major one today, this morning. And when God willing, we are going to have some refreshings. I don't know when. But before Corona ends, because I guess when there is Corona people, there are many people who are free. Walimu are free. I can easily call for a meeting and they come. Other people are free. But when we call these meetings, even if you are sure, be likely to call them on a Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Come for those meetings. Because we cannot teach everything in these hours. We cannot teach everything. Now, guys, we need to go to another level.
Yes.
For us to call a preacher from Nigeria, a preacher from America, there are some things God is putting in our hearts that I don't know when we'll ever teach them. And the only problem is that we have no time to teach these things. And so after we prayed, we wanted to know what spirit is ruling here. And God showed to many people the serpent spirit. The spirit coming in the form of a snake. It is not the first time that God has shown that in Chogoria, but I think we have not been taking it very seriously. But the days that God spoke very clearly is after the days of prayer and fasting, the 21 days, God showed people either attacking spirits or serpents and then they die. When I say serpent, I'm just talking of snake. Attacking snakes that die. Others were shown by God dead snakes. And it started making sense now when God started showing us that the spirit of the snake has been ruling in Chogoria. It started fighting it because a few times I would wake up at night and feel the presence of a snake in my house. And I would get a torch and look at every corner and I don't get any snake. And I would wonder, why am I feeling that? Why am I feeling like the snake? There is a snake in the house. Not that I fear snakes, by the way, I was brought up in the generation that did fear snakes. Because in our generation, when we were small children, we were commonly told that if you kill a snake, God adds 7 days to your life. And so I remember every Saturday when we were not in school, we would go down the valley, down in the bushes in the river to look for a snake to kill so that you would add 7 days. And that one took away the fear of snakes from me. Because once you get one, you have to struggle. Who killed it first so that you get the 7 days? And so when I say I feel the presence of a snake, not that I fear one, I can easily kill a snake. I have no problem with that. Doesn't matter the size, I have no problem with the snakes, and I don't know why I only fear the caterpillar. I don't fear snakes. But I can run away when I see a caterpillar. I don't know why. So God put it clearly. And many brethren came and told me, Pastor, I dreamt and saw this snake and it died in there. And I was very sure that we have killed this snake. That's what I got in me. But then 2 days ago, God comes another again dramatically. Last night was one and he gives me a funny dream. God showed me my chicken speaking to me. Kuku zinaongea. Niko na jogo mkubwa hapo. Nikaona ananiongelesha ananiuliza kwani hauoni? Yule nyoka mliua ameanza kufufuka. Now this was a chicken speaking. In a dream. So I wondering now this chicken is speaking. I see you think I trust you. And then the big cock kept telling me, come and see. And I saw myself going to the kitchen and to the chicken house. And I saw a big snake lying there. And when I started talking, I saw that the snake lift the head. It was bruised on the head. It came and cut me over the kitchen. But then it started moving again. And the head was telling me, you see, you killed it, but it has come up again. When I was still in the dream, I had I had a noise of chicken outside, like there is a bila kuku zinalia wakati kuna mwizi wa kuku ama mnyama ameingia kwa kuku. I established now it was in the neighborhood, not in my chicken. But I woke up When I woke up now, I was wondering, now this, I've dreamt about chicken, and now the chicken making noise, and there was silence all over outside. And then the chicken started crowing, and I realized it was 3 a.m. It was 3 a.m., but when the chicken are making noise, God is just confirming that what you are dreaming with the chicken, telling you there is a funny spirit outside, and the chicken can sense it. The chicken can sense that they are making noise as if there is a thief outside. There is no thief. The chicken can sense that spirit. So, brethren, we have dealt a big blow to the snake spirit that has been ruling Jehovah. It's trying to rise again, to start operating again. That's why I'm saying we are entering another round of prayers, because this spirit must bow. This spirit must die. Praise the Lord. And so this morning I wanted to speak about the serpent spirit, and the topic is crushing the serpent spirit. Crushing the serpent spirit. I'll read from the book of Genesis, chapter 1, from verse 1 to 16. Genesis chapter 1 from verse 1 to 16. It's a long one, but let us just read so that we understand. Now the serpent was more subtle than that any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. And he had said unto the woman, yeah, had God said, you shall not eat of every tree in the garden? And the woman said unto the serpent, we may eat of any fruit of the tree of the garden, but of the tree, of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God has said, you shall not eat of it, neither shall you touch it, lest you die. And the serpent said unto the woman, yeah, you shall not surely die. For God does know that in the day that you eat thereof, then your eyes shall be opened, and you shall be as gods, knowing good and evil. And when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was pleasant to the eyes, and a tree to be desired to make one wise, she took of the fruit thereof, and did eat, and gave also unto her husband with her, and he did eat. And the eyes of both of them were opened, and they knew that they were naked, and they sewed fig leaves together, and made themselves aprons. And they heard the voice of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And Adam and he and Eve hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. And the Lord God called unto Adam and said unto him, where art thou? And he said, I heard thy voice in the garden, and was afraid because I was naked, and hid myself. And he said, who told thee that thou wast naked? Hast thou eaten of the tree whereof I commanded thee that thou shalt not eat? And the man said, the woman whom thou givest to me, she gave me the fruit, and I did eat. And the Lord God said to the woman, what is this that thou hast done? And the woman said, the serpent beguiled me, and I did eat. And the Lord God said unto the serpent, because thou hast done this, thou hast cast above all the cattle, and above the beasts of the field, upon the belly shalt thou go, and dust shalt thou eat all the days of thy life. And I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and the seed and her seed. It shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise her heel. And the woman, he said, I will greatly multiply thy sorrow and thy conception in sorrow. Thou shalt bring forth children, and thy desire shall be that of the husband, and He shall rule over you. He shall rule over you. You are losing dominion. Now the problem with this message, every statement here is a message. Because I wanted to tell the women the reason why the Bible says the man is the head of the woman. This is where it started. That's where women lost dominion. When God created them, they were equal. Men and women were equal. Wangekuwa na timetable kwa nyumba, wanasema today I'm in charge, this week I'm in charge, then the next week the woman is in charge. But because of the spirit of the serpent, the woman lost dominion. And God said, from now, you are subordinate to the man. It doesn't matter how many women right groups come up, they will never change that. If they try to change that, they will suffer for it. It doesn't matter how many degrees a woman has. If you change this order of God, you will suffer for it. Remain in this order. It was put by God. Today we were not talking about that order. It's only that I say every statement chase as someone, and I'm so much tempted. So I want us to know that every geographical area, every geographical region has a spirit responsible. So there is a responsible spirit for every geographical region. That's why when Daniel is praying, God, the angel comes and says, from when you started praying, I was sent with an answer from heaven, but withheld me. The prince of Persia was the demon that was in charge of that region, was the spirit that was in charge of that region. And the spirit of Persia, that demon of Persia, that prince of Persia, could not allow David to get the answer. Oh, Daniel. So there is a spirit in every geographical area. If you are a believer, the right thing to do when you go to a new area is to try and survey in the spirit and know what spirit rules this area. And that is what we lost in Chukwuka. For a long time, nobody understood what spirit rules Chukwuka. One time, some brethren were casting out demons in a place far from here. It was a group of brethren who were exposed to a lot of traveling. Some brethren told them, this Chukwuka is a place in Meru. It is not in hell. So, what support were these spirits asking for? They were asking support from the spirit that is in charge of Chukwuka. That means it is a strong one. This spirit that rules Chukwuka is a strong one. That's why they were asking for support. Descriptions and manifestations. An area can be manned by more than one spirit. That's another thing that we need to know. Like in Chukwuka, the major spirit is the spirit of the serpent. But also very active in Chukwuka is the spirit of the dog. The spirit of the dog and the spirit of the serpent. Today I'll leave the serpent. We will come to the spirit of the dog another day. Spirits share some characteristics with the Holy Spirit. So the difference is that there are evil spirits and there is the Holy Spirit. But all of them are spirits. So some of the characteristics that they share is the characteristic of access. Access. What do I mean by access? For the Holy Spirit to come into this church, he doesn't need our permission. He doesn't need to have doors open. He can just come in. He's a spirit. So evil spirits can also come like that. They can have access into your house. They can come into your bedroom. They even go to heaven. So we said that. Yeah. One time God called a meeting for the people in heaven and the devil came. They have access. Spirits can just penetrate and find themselves in places. You know, one time we went to a school and we tried to cast out demon and the principal was hard on us and said, get out of my school! My school! told you that? Spirits can be anywhere. They can have access. Number two characteristic that they share with the Spirit of God is the ability to influence. The ability to influence. That's why the Bible keeps saying, and these prophets, led by the Spirit, prophets led by the Spirit. And the Bible says, and the Spirit of God came upon Samson and started influencing Samson, and Samson did things that no man can explain. How you can get a big gate and carry on your shoulders and take it to the mountain and leave it there. Influenced by the Spirit. The Spirit of God came upon Philip and took Philip like an helicopter. See? Without a vehicle, he just went. The Spirit of God has ability to influence. Evil spirits have ability to influence. They can manipulate situations. They can cause you to do things, and then you wonder, how did I do this? Was I in my mind when I did this? Actually, you are not. You are under influence. You know, there are some people who say, I did this. There is a person who defied a small girl, and when he was taken to court, I was interested because he was related to me. And when he went to court, the case became very easy. He said that I cannot do this in my sound mind. I only did this because I was under the influence of alcohol. 10 years for doing that. He was asking for. So there are some things that you do when the Spirit influences you, just trying to make sure that you're not right with God. So spirits can influence. Number two, spirits can live when conditions are not favorable. That's a good one. The Holy Spirit of God can live with your mouth, making the conditions favorable for demons. They can remain there. So they can live. The other thing, only one thing that they share with the Holy Spirit so that make progress is that they can also decide to create a dwelling. Just dwelling. And create a territory there. The Holy Spirit can be so impressed with a person and decide to create a dwelling in that person. The Holy Spirit can be so happy with a church and decide to make a dwelling there. So that you only enter that church and you feel, wow, I have not even prayed. Nobody prayed for me. I'm feeling the presence of God. Brethren, we should get there. I only one time I went to work in Gidongo Health Center, and I was told of a brother in the neighborhood who was crippled since he was born. The brother is not able to walk out of the house, but he had another brother who is a pastor in a pastoralized church. And all what this brother who is a pastor used to do is to bring video cassettes. Wakati ni kuwa wakati wa video. Unajua some of you have never seen a video cassette. Nimu unajua tu CD na MP3. Unawakati kulikuwa na video cassette. And this brother kept bringing the video cassettes to him. And so when we heard of him and we was told he's born again, we said, why not visit this brother? He's born again after all. Situ kama msembele. What surprised me is when we entered the door, you would feel the wave of the Spirit of God hit you. At some point, I was wondering, why is not even healed? Because there's so much power in this house. The house was just power packed. So, brethren, we can create a dwelling for God's Spirit in our houses. We can create His dwelling here. You can create His dwelling in your car. You can create His dwelling in your workplace. Praise the Lord. And I pray that this church will be a dwelling place for the Holy Spirit. But unfortunately, you can also create a dwelling place for devils. Until when they are chased from other places, they say, dwell in Mumbai. They come to your home. Imagine. They are coming home. Or they are coming into you. Yesterday, I hired a man of God. No, 2 days ago, a man of God preaching and saying how they were casting out demons. And one demon says, this one, she's no favorite for us. She's our favorite. And the demon says, we would rather let 200 people free than this one. Who you? My goodness. She gives us the right condition to live. This one we are not releasing. for demons. By the way, a church can also do that. Create a very good dwelling environment for demons. And you go to that church and you go out full of demons. There are preachers who preach and they release demons. So again, don't listen to every preacher. Today I'm not a good father, I'm giving restrictions. But you can also get demons from preachers. Did I tell you when I was leading in Nairobi? There's a brother who was preaching in a church, who was a very prayerful brother in the church. And he was always praying in church in tongues. Until another pastor from another country came. A pastor comes from India. And asked the pastor, wait a minute, what is this man praying? The pastor says, he's just praying in tongues. Just praying in tongues. He said, no. This guy is insulting God properly. He's insulting God. You are thinking he's praying in tongues in the church and insulting God in the Indian language. And then the pastor called him for interrogation. When did you start speaking in tongues? And he said, I found this Indian preacher in town. He was talking about Barabarani too. And he was praying for people. I went, he laid hands on me and I started speaking in tongues. So he was given demons to insult God. I pray that soon God will allow me to hear what people are praying in tongues. So that we don't have somebody here insulting God and cursing God in tongues and we think you are speaking in tongues. Na kumbe uliwekelewa mikono. So brethren, there are some preachers who will lay hands on you and you get trapped by the devil. So those are some of the characteristics that the evil spirits share with the Spirit of God. Am I going to finish this message? God help me. Ephesians chapter 6 verse 12, we know this. We do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers. So we are fighting principalities and powers, brethren. Let us just measure into this spirit of the serpents. Time is much gone. I have to jump a big deal of the notes. The spirit of the serpent is the earliest mentioned in the Bible. We have seen it right in the book of Genesis. Came to Eve and spoke to Eve. So it is the earliest spirit spoken about in the Bible. It is also referred to as the spirit of the dragon. It is also called Leviathan. Leviathan in the book of Isaiah 27 verse 1. Isaiah 27 verse 1. The Bible says, in that day, the Lord will, with his sword and great and strong sword, will punish Leviathan, the piercing serpent. Leviathan, the piercing serpent. Even Leviathan, the crooked serpent. And he shall slay the dragon that is in the sea. So when you hear the spirit of Leviathan, it is the same spirit of serpents. I know some of you might have heard Pastor Shukuku sometime casting out the spirit of Leviathan. First time we walk on in the spirit. There's no days a time we were praying and they always had him casting out the spirit of Leviathan, the spirit of the serpent. It is the same spirit we are talking about. How does this spirit manifest? I'm trying to be very sure now. We have just 15 minutes to finish this service. How does the spirit, actually we should have finished. Allow me to take 15 minutes and finish. Number one, the serpent spirit manifests in subtlety. The Bible says, now the serpent was the most subtle. Was the most subtle. So when we're talking of this, was the most subtle. What do we mean? That it was, subtlety is cunning cleverness. You seem clever, but you are cunning. See, you come here, sana, ni ukaluru kwa namwingi. Ukaluru ni cunningness. Uko mkaluru sana. Actually, in the right language, wanasemanga kushora. Wewe ni mshori sana, mmakaa mshori. Unatakiwa kushora sana. Cunning, very cunning. So the spirit of the serpent is a cunning spirit. It has destroyed churches. You find a church like this one, moving very well. Then suddenly the pastor starts becoming very cunning. Very cunning. Hata anapata pesa anaanza kufichafichia zingine. Very cunning pastor. Starting manipulating people in cunningness to give money. To give money. You can't trust him with your time. Mtumie kwa simu yake haitafika kanisani. Cunningness. Cunningness has destroyed churches. So one characteristic of the serpent spirit is cunningness, operating cunningness. Those who have been in Chogoria for some time know that Chogoria, we have seen enough of cunningness. Among pastors, among members of the church, cunningness. Even here, we have enough cunning brothers and sisters. Very cunning. Not because they want to be cunning, but they are living in Chogoria where the spirit of the serpent operates. So when you see a cunning brother, a cunning sister, the Bible says we are not operating, we are not wrestling against flesh and blood. Don't see them, see a spirit behind them. Cunningness. Number two, manifest in casting doubt what God has said to stop one from landing on God's promise. So casting doubt on what God has said, to make sure you don't land on God's promise. So that God will keep saying very good things about you. And then the serpent spirit brings doubts. Brings doubts. And starts saying, did God say he'll give you rest? Did God say he'll establish you? Did God say he's giving you dominion? Every time you hear that, sometimes he brings a pain in the stomach and you listen. Did God say he'll give you dominion over sickness and disease? Now listen to what you are feeling. You listen to that one, you are obeying the spirit of the serpent. There are sometimes I feel sick and I refuse to tell anybody. I refuse to tell anybody. Time I felt a lot of pain and I said I'm not even telling my wife. This one I won't tell anybody. I'll just keep quiet. And they start saying, pain you must go, pain you must go. In a car in the end. Because I don't want the devil to start creating that doubt in me. I must land on the promise of God. Praise the Lord. So I refuse to bow to the spirit of the serpent of casting doubts. Number three, this spirit finds ease in operating through women. Finds ease in operating through women. Sisters, praise the Lord. I pray that you understand me. Musikatai kuja kanisa next Sunday. Please understand. But you know, we had an argument last year with some people and we asked, when this spirit was addressing Eve, where was Adam? And we argued and some of us were saying Adam was not there. I think I was also among the people that were saying Adam was not there. But when I read the Bible now, I get he was right there. He was right there with Eve. But the serpent of the spirit finds it easy to deal with women. So he came and Eve is there and you the spirit can talk to you when your husband is not even listening. He is there and I ask his out of your people. And I can't put another to Badika Mood. What have I done? What have I done? What have I done now? Mood in the Badika Garden in the house. Because the spirit of the serpent can minister without the other person hearing them go for once. The way that the same person is going to go for once. But it is true. So they talk and talk and they have a conversation and Adam is not hearing anything until he's given a fruit. I'm sure if he knew it has come from the snake, he would have refused. Lakini hakuwa anasikia. Alifikia ni bibi yake ameanza kuchanuka. Nasi anachanuka, anachanuliwa huko nyuma nyuma, anachanuliwa na pepo. So this is spirit lies operating through women. And I see that there is a man of God who said, since the days of Adam, the devil has not spoken to women. Pastor Lai may hear this, but he's the one who said, he said in a men's conference, it's only men who are there. And he said, since the days of Adam and Eve, the devil has not stopped talking to women. So, As much as we love them, many times we have to be king. He's coming at Congresa Mama Victor and Kemen. You have paid for the same thing. I know my wife, she doesn't talk like this. So we only gonna keep it on your own. So the spirit likes talking through women. A few women that it's before that, when we talk of the woman in the Bible, what do we mean?
Church.
That is one meaning, not even this church. One meaning in the Bible, that when you find the word meaning in the Bible, the woman in the Bible, it is a good meaning, literally the female gender. So understand that. Sometimes it talks about the female gender. When the Bible says it is good for a man not to touch a woman, then it starts talking about not the church, female gender, literally. Are we together?
Yes.
Number two, it could be talking about the channel of reproduction. Channel of reproductive, when it talks about the women. Channel of reproductive. Eve was a channel of the reproduction. Adam carried the seed, but he could not reproduce alone. He's given a channel of reproduction. So when the Bible talks about the channel of the woman, it talks about the channel of reproduction. Number three, it also talks about it also means the apostate church. The apostate church. Apostate means fallen church. The church that has fallen. So when we are saying that he likes dealing through women, it is true, he likes dealing with fallen churches. A church can fall under the spirit of the serpent, multiplies through there. The Bible talks of women also, it talks of enticement and defilement. Enticement and defilement. I wish I had time to go through all this in detail so that you understand. But just write that and God will help you to understand. So the spirit of the serpent lies operating through defilement and enticement. I think alone will handle one thing and then we go home. Then we continue next time. It's in the quest. Because they will not allow me. There is a way I may rush and we don't get anything. So you will allow me to handle. There are a few women that the devil used through the spirit of the serpent and then we continue next time. Now that means I must continue in this service so that. Because if I start in another service, I have to keep the background. One woman that was used by the devil through the spirit of the serpent was Eve. What did the spirit want to achieve through Eve? We have talked of casting doubt, number one. So this spirit uses women to cast doubt and tempting by appetite. Casting doubt and tempting by appetite. The Bible says, when she saw it is good for food, tempting your appetite. There is a guy who was dealing with appetite here. Did I deal with appetite? The four appetites? The four appetites, did I talk that? If I didn't talk, I will talk another day. But the devil can test your appetite. Appetite. Number two, the spirit used a woman called Michal, the wife of David. Then Michal was the wife of David. By the way, the devil knew what God had said about David. And so when he comes to kill Goliath, he asks, what shall this person be given? And the devil saw an opportunity to bring. Now the devil knew he can operate through this. The time of marriage is a time that the devil can very fast supply a wife for you, brothers. The time of marriage, the devil can supply a husband for you, sisters. Because he wants to bring somebody who, through whom he can use, he can advance his agenda in your life. So in the book of 2 Samuel chapter 6 verse 12, what does the spirit of serpent do through Michal? It is discouragement. Discouragement. She comes and says, see how the king of Israel danced before people. See how the king of Israel embarrassed himself before people. If you are in a mission that is in the field that is ordained for you by God, you will encounter this spirit.
There are some people who are the ordinance of God. They are ordained by God to do business until this spirit will manifest. There are some people who are ordained by God for profession. They just prosper in profession. They just prosper. At the condition on a position, they can all get A. And she has been ordained by God for that. She can even get promotions without bribing anybody. Prepared by God for that. There are some people who are prepared by God just to sing here. They just sing and the Spirit of God comes down. When you are in any place of service that is ordained for you by God, you will encounter the spirit of the serpent. And one way that the spirit will come is to discourage you. When you think you have done a very good job, who may for we will have a visit beside. Alafu anatoka hapo nje. Alikuwa na hivi kuona kako na ngoma mpya. Kule kabisa. Kule asili nchi yesi. The spirit of discouragement. Through Marco. Spirit of discouragement. There are many preachers who preach wonderful messages. Then they fear to get back home. Because Marco is waiting at home. Marco is waiting. When you see pastors who stay in the wanatoka kanisani saa moja usiku, and sometimes they say God has told them to spend the night praying in the church. It is not God who told them home. There is trouble at home. Marco is waiting. See, watch the kai kanisa. Sisters, please be a blessing to your husbands. And the vice versa. Brothers, be a blessing to your wives. There are some wives who have spent a life of crying throughout. The serpent to take away joy from your house through discouragement. Number three, the spirit of the serpent is related to Jezebel. Spirit of Jezebel. What was the mission of the spirit of Jezebel? The spirit of Jezebel, Jezebel's mission is to intimidate. Number one, to intimidate. He hears that Elijah has killed the prophet of Baal, and she sends a message and says, let it be done to me also. If tomorrow I die like this, I will not have done to you what you have done to the prophets. And a man who has killed 850 prophets runs away from one woman. Imagine, you have all those prophets were men. He killed them 850 alone. Then one woman speaks with the spirit of the serpent. Spirit of the serpent, and the man of God goes into hiding. And many times when you are doing work of God, you can get intimidated. Get very intimidated. That's why when we even try to build this small wall here, you know they try to intimidate us. How put up one? Until somebody calls me. Do you know we can demolish that wall? And now, because I thought God worked in me, Mungu alinisaidia, siku kuanga namna hiyo. Siku kuanga namna hiyo. Nikamwambia msibomoe. Kama ingekuwa last year. Ningemwitia ndoa na muulize swali. Ningemwitia ndoa na nimuulize. Kama ingekuwa last year. God is working on me. But when they try to intimidate us, I knew this is the spirit of the devil trying to intimidate us. The serpent spirit. Number, the other thing that the spirit of Jezebel does is to cause depression. To cause depression. There are some people who need to be delivered from the spirit of Jezebel for you to enjoy life. You always feel depressed. Because after Jezebel has spoken, the next place we find Elijah was somewhere hiding and saying, God, they have killed everybody. I'm the only one left. Very depressed. The spirit of Jezebel causes depression. It is not Jezebel, it is the spirit of the serpent. Finally, Herodias. De Mata o Salome.
Mama Salo.
Mama Salo was operating in the spirit of the serpent. What did the spirit of the serpent, John chapter 6, verse 21, what did this spirit want to achieve through Mama Salo? It is number one, malaise. She was acting very maliciously against John the Baptist. Very malicious. And there's a spirit of malice in the church. By the way, the spirit of malice gave back the spirit of murder. She had even killed. So it is malice and murder. And she operates in sisters very well. For those who are not, who are not, who are not, who sister. The spirit of malice and murder is called in one word gossip. Every time you find people gossiping about you, they have only one intention, to finish you. No! Their intention is to finish you. Their intention is to kuzo na bwana bwana yako. Their intention is to foot a curse. This is the spirit of the serpent operating through Herodias. That spirit is true. Do you know there are many churches that have been broken in Jogodia? Not for any fact. Ni pastor alikuja akaambia pastor Shukuku, unajua vile pastor Irene alikuwa anasema kuhusu wewe. And the spirit starts building another spirit in you. Alafu unaangalia pastor Irene. Ni mwana anatoka upaga spisi. How can I start with such a pastor? Not that Pastor Irene did anything. He didn't do anything. It's only the spirit of Herodias. In Aitisha Kizoya, the spirit of Herodias is saying, I must get the head of that pastor. Now, pastors of Michukiana, pastor of Michukiana, for nothing. Members of Michukiana, I am praying that Mama Salos in our midst will be saved and delivered. Praise the Lord. The spirit of the serpent. It is time for the second service. I have not finished. Can we continue next Sunday?
Yes.
Are you going to come?
Yes.
Yes, let's continue next Sunday. So that we expose this spirit. So that we completely kill it. But no, we have a spirit to deal with. The spirit of the serpent. I have not even said what is this. Pastor Shikuku, come and bless us before you go to Mudeo. Pastor Shikuku and the team that is going to Mudeo.